I'd like to remind you that even though we have entitled this section as What Can Go Wrong, of course, diseases can go wrong. So there are autoimmune diseases and there are immune deficiency syndromes. But in the hypersensitivity reactions, it's not necessarily wrong. It's a right thing. It's the way the body deals with immune reactions. So let's talk about the classic four types of hypersensitivity reactions. And the first type is generally known as immediate hypersensitivity or an acute allergic reaction. In type two, we have antibody-mediated hypersensitivity. Very often, antibodies attacking surfaces of cells, sometimes fixing complement. In the third type, it's what we call immune complex hypersensitivity. We have floating immune complexes consisting of antigens and antibodies, and they deposit in areas to cause damage. Often, this could be glomerular basement membrane or synovial cells. And in the fourth type of cell-mediated hypersensitivity, we can think of it in terms of a classic skin reaction to tuberculosis or hypersensitivity based purely on cellular reactions. In type 1, we have, by immediate, we mean seconds to minutes. So this is these are items which can are often described as an acute allergy, sometimes fatal, as an anaphylactic shock, edema, dyspnea, and in all types of type 1 immediate hypersensitivity, there's an allergen exposure, and then there's an immediate reaction. And often this consists in mast cell degranulation, vasodilatation, vascular leakage, and smooth muscle spasm. These are things that can be perceived as seconds to minutes following the allergen exposure. In a late phase, there may be some cellular infiltrates like neutrophils, T cells, and of course, classical eosinophils, which are regarded as the cellular infiltrate of allergies. In type 2 situations, we have antibodies attached to cell surfaces. Often, they can result in complement fixation if the sequence or cascade of complement proteins is triggered off following these antibodies attaching to cell surfaces. Often they can result in phagocytosis of the cell as well as a term called opsonization, which I can describe as basting the turkey or coating the cells or particles to get them ready for phagocytosis. In type 1 hypersensitivity, often the end result is lysis or destruction or breaking down of the cells by virtue of the antibodies fixing complement and now actually causing breaking of the cell membrane and therefore cell rupture and ultimately lysis or dissolving of the cell. In type 3 diseases, we have situations in which we have antibodies attacking cells directly. For example, in autoimmune hemolytic anemia, the older term, we have antibodies attacking the surface of red cells. In ITP, idiopathic thrombocytopenic purpura, we have antibodies attacking the surface of platelets. In Goodpasture syndrome, we have antibodies attacking type 4 collagen of glomerular basement membrane causing a nephritis or renal failure, as well as antigens in the lung as well. In rheumatic fever, in myasthenia gravis, in Graves' disease, in pernicious anemia, these are always all very, very clear-cut examples of antibodies attacking the body's own tissue, whether it's muscle, whether it's elements of the thyroid gland, or whether it's the body's intrinsic factor resulting in mal or no absorption of vitamin B12. In type 3 hypersensitivity diseases, we have immune complexes. What is an immune complex? An immune complex is a combination of an antigen and antibody, and the antigen is the body's own substance. Well, now that you have antibodies attacking body's own substance, where do they go? Well, they can go where they're being attacked. Often, they go into the vascular system and they float around. And one place that they love to go is glomerular basement membrane of the kidney. The GBM is a magnet for immune complexes of all types. So are blood vessels themselves. So is skin, as in lupus. And so are joints or any synovial lined cavity. They are also a big magnet for immune complexes. Common type 3 diseases is, first of all, the mother of all autoimmune diseases, lupus or systemic lupus erythematosus, poly, also known as periarteritis nodosa, post-streptococcal glomerulonephritis, as well as some general systemic reactions. One of them is a skin reaction called arthritis reaction, usually resulting in hours after the exposure, or a more generalized form of immune complex serum sickness, which can last for days. Let's talk about type 4 hypersensitivity. Type 4 hypersensitivity can be best defined as a cell coming in direct contact with an antigen. Does that sound like cell-mediated immunity? That's exactly what it is. For example, in the tuberculin skin reaction, we have a protein derivative of tuberculin, which causes a direct cellular contact. Sometimes it results in granuloma formation, but it's definitely an inflammatory reaction in which direct antigens come in contact with T cells, causing a direct cellular infiltrative type of reaction. So once again, as a summary, there are four types of hypersensitivity diseases. There's acute allergic reaction. There's antibodies directed against cell surfaces. There's immune complexes is number 3. And there's the classical delayed hypersensitivity reaction as type 4. Let's call it a day for now, and we'll start out with slide number 34. Thank you very much.